right, welcome back, and thank you so much for staying with Morning Live. We're still continuing our discussion. In fact, it's a debate on political killings here in KwaZulu-Natal, and our reporter, Ayanda Mhlongo, is there for us talking to all the different parties that are involved. We have also requested you to become part of the discussion here at Morning Live. At Morning Live SABC is our Twitter handle, and the question that we're asking this morning is, what must be done to stop political killings in KwaZulu-Natal? You can just send them through, and we'll be able to read them, and of course, Ayanda will also convey the message to the panel there. That's the question on the screen. What must be done to stop political killings in KwaZulu-Natal? At Morning Live SABC, it's our Twitter handle. Let's hear how you see things. All right, let's go back to Ayanda. Ayanda, it's back to you.
Melissa, thanks to you once again. Yeah, that is the question today that we are asking, we'll be posing to our political leaders that have joined us in this special debate. We're looking at how we're going to bring an end to political killings in the province of KwaZulu-Natal. Now, I've got guests now joining me, and now we've got the leaders of the IFP, we've got the Democratic Alliance as well as the NFP, Mr. Joshua Mazibogo from the IFP, Zwakele Mncwango, the leader of the DA in the KZN, as well as Professor Nhlanhla Kubisa. Good morning, gentlemen. Thank you very much for your time.
Good morning.
So, Mazibu, I'm going to start with you looking at the history of KwaZulu-Natal, violence in KwaZulu-Natal, particularly where the IFP has been concerned. And we're moving our period to the time, let's say, the Commission of Inquiry, the Moirano Commission, is looking from the period of from 2011, which was a time when the IFP saw a number of attacks on its members as well. Again, people might have said, or some were saying, that it was a result of the split within the party, where we saw a large number of your supporters then leaving to then form the then a new party, which was the NFP. Would you say that that was at the center of the conflict at that time in 2011, when we saw those attacks, and particularly IFP strongholds and the hostels in northern parts of KwaZulu-Natal, areas which were regarded as IFP strongholds?
Yeah, yes, indeed. There was an element of competition for political space. But at the same time, there was a criminal element that sought to ride on those differences and conflicts. Because you'll remember that, you must know that actually there's a high unemployment in KwaZulu-Natal in South Africa. So politics being the only occupation, if I may say, where you don't have to submit a CV, where the advert does not say what qualification do you have. It is easy for one to say this is the only way through which I can get employment. So there was an element of political competition, but at the same time there was also a criminal element involved in those conflicts.
Professor Kubisa, the NFP, you were the new kids on the block at the time, and the same question to you. You became victims during that time. I remember you and I spent even quite a time in Gomasha Hostel in northern parts of KwaZulu-Natal, where your members who had newly joined the party became victims of the violence. Do you saw it as the fact that you are now entering into strongholds, you were taking support from the IFP?
No, absolutely. And there was some kind of contestation, heavy contestation during that period, but then, and of course, I fully concur with Joshua that there was an element that crept in, which is an element of politics being seen as a career, and the whole issue of getting into politics being careerism. But then we sat down. I remember quite vividly that the two leaders, the president of the NFP and the Prince of Kwapindanga and the President of the IFP had to convene a task team. Mm-hmm. I led the task team, and from the IFP it was led by Inkosi Umzamo Buthelezi. Mm-hmm. And we sat down and we tried to iron out and to see what is it that was a problem between us. And of course we identified certain issues. One, derogatory remarks. Two, songs. Three, it was the issue of music. Music that was sung, and also some slogans as well. And we said to ourselves, oh, these are the issues that we must deal with, and we cascaded that down to the local level. Mm. And it really worked. Of course, many people died, And one soul is one too many, but we are able to harness it with immediate effect, and we dealt with it. And of course, we identified other things like the police being present, especially at the hostel. The heavy presence of the police was needed. And then two, we said to ourselves, we must also factor in the community as well. The municipality must come in. And of course, there was this multi-party committee task team that was led by Honorable Willis Mthunu. And we believe all those things put together try to calm down the whole issue of violence, especially within the province. And you could see that between 2012 to 2014, it was a bit subsiding. Of course, there were pockets of it here and there, but it was not the same. And I fully concur with Joshua Mazibuko that there was really contestation, but we tried to harness it.
Very interesting points that you raise, Prof, and that leaders play a huge responsibility as well. They play a critical role. When you're talking about simple things that we might not notice or fueling tensions amongst supporters on the ground, and they say that when the elephants fight, it's the grass that suffers. Yeah. That it, there's also a certain level of responsibility that leaders also have to take. In the rallies, we're seeing mass rallies, CADIS forums nowadays, and the messages that the political leaders are giving to their members, that is what then causes the tensions amongst them.
I must really say, and that is sacrosanct. You know, we must really salute the leader of the NFP and also the leader of the IFP for trying by all means to ensure that such flames of violence had to come to an end. And of course, that task team played a very pivotal role. And I was part of it. I was leading from the NFP, and the IFP had to bring in Inkosi Mzamo Buthelezi. And we identified these small things. Of course, there were major things that we identified, and we ensured that we got into the radix of it, we got into the roots of it, and we dealt with that. But I must say that it didn't come to an end abruptly. There was a need to ensure that the process was taken forward.
Back to you, Mr. Mazibuko. Prof has spoken about the talks. I remember there were the four-a-side, the five-a-side, the six-a-side. Yeah. And it, clearly when those discussions were being held, we started to see change. We started to see stability. We started to see peace. We started to see tolerance, even during campaign periods. I mean, there was a time when in the hostel, for example, Prof, and yourself, Mr. Mazibuko, we were there with you as well, where members were able to laugh together and dance to, you know, dance together. So, Mr. Those talks, how, looking at now the violence that we see now, obviously it's the ANC that seems to be in a bit of a trouble at the moment. How can they apply what you used then, the four-side talks, to try and solve the problems that we're seeing now?
Actually, what the prophet said is fundamental in that it takes leaders coming to terms with the fact that they are in the same boat. They'll either swim or sink together. So they must try to ensure that they all swim. Until the leaders come to that realization, then you won't see the end of violence. So it took leaders in both organizations to come together and lead the campaign for peace. If you look back at our case with the ANC as well, same thing happened. It took leaders to take cudgels against violence and say enough is enough, and be seen to be disciplining and all those members who seem to be stray from the cause that leaders have charted.
Let me bring in now the Democratic Alliance as well. Of course, well, your members not entirely affected, but of course, in order for you as well as a party to be able to work, you've got councillors in various municipalities, you're on the ground. Stability of the province is also important for yourselves as the Democratic Alliance.
Yeah, first let me say it's not true that we're affected. We don't need to see someone being killed first before we can admit we are being affected. We are affected when there's intolerance. But one must say, firstly, must appreciate the role of multi-party peace committee. It was initiated by the former MEC for Transport and Security, which is Ubabu Willis Mthunu. That committee have actually paved the way because we managed to sit together as leaders in the province. But firstly, what was main important was to admit that there's a problem. Because the challenges we face today is around admission. and also able to do introspection, because at that time we were facing a multi-party intolerance. And what we see today, we see more of an intra-party intolerance, where internally as Pol Pot parties we're having challenges, but we fail to admit as Pol Pot parties before the problems. But also we must admit the problem we are facing today is around corruption, because we keep talking about corruption and we don't hear much about people being arrested for corruption. We talk about corruption every day, we expose corrupt individuals, but there's no prosecution. I don't know when last we heard about someone who've been arrested for corruption and get prosecuted. Now the challenge is, if we keep denying these issues that are affecting us as political parties internally, we are really facing a disaster in this province, especially because if you look at those who are corrupt, are the one moved around within government institution, but those exposing corruption, whistleblowers, are the one getting killed. And I think it's high time that as leaders, okay, we look at this tender system also and how it affects us.
All right, I'm going to hold you right there. We will continue, gentlemen, with our discussions. We're going to take a short break and our debate, of course, continues after this.